100 years ago, this country was like a newborn child. Men then came on horseback seeking gold. Some came on ships looking for furs. Others in wagons searching for unplowed land. They came seeking freedom. They built, they planted, they traded. The child grew. It prospered. It became a nation, a vast empire stretching from sea to sea, a land of the free and the strong.
Sardis expanded to a full junior secondary school enrolling grades 8 through 12, and in June 1967 presented to the district the first graduating class from Sardis Secondary of about 90 students.
In 1969 to 70, the administration, library, and gymnasium were expanded. Blue jeans were outlawed in school, and anyone coming to school wearing them had to sit in the library. A highlight of this year was the Sardis band performance in Osaka, Japan, for Expo 70. 2 years of preparation preceded this tour. Mr. Hoogie and the band parents committee were instrumental in organizing the fundraising activities, such as the 30-hour band marathon, the 3.5-day teeter-totter marathon, workdays, and cabarets.
It became tradition for students to scratch their initials on the activity room pole. Mr. Shannon faithfully repainted the pole on St. Patrick's Day each and every year. It became affectionately known as Shannon's Pole, and in 1971 through 1972, the following poem was written about this pole, author unknown.
There were three poles within a large room. They made three wishes to be a fine bed, Fit for a king to lie on, he said. The second a boat wanted to be, to carry the king away o'er the sea. I am what I am, and I be not a mole. That's how it is, so said the third pole. I have only one wish that I could wish on. That's to be remembered long after I'm gone. A teacher came and felled the first pole. Soon the form of a bed shall be my soul. But was it in the scorn or was it in anger? He found himself fashioned into a manger. The third pole was left, and he was left all alone. Still he remained, was still growing strong. And the wind in the activity room kept murmuring on, "You will be remembered long after you're gone."
In 1973 to 74, Sardis was 17 years old. Streaking was a popular occurrence. Sardis students won the first annual pancake eating contest in competition against Chilliwack, an event which made the front page of the Progress. The concert band traveled to California for a musical convention and toured Disneyland. Sardis Falcons football teams were Fraser Valley champs. In the Shrine Bowl during the final quarter of play at Empire Stadium, they lost to Notre Dame.
1974 to 75. This was the year of One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, David Bowie Wannabes, sock hops to the tunes of Creedence Clearwater Revival, and driving an Austin Mini down the hallway and getting it off the roof. Good times were had hanging around Shannon's pole.
Those were the days, my friend, we thought they'd never end, for we were young and sure to have our way.